Hi, good day to everyone. Today, let's see what the types of surge protection devices are, and how to choose the best combination for a premises. Any building, whether commercial, industrial or residential, requires surge protection for its electrical installation system, if the power supply is by overhead lines. First, let's see how the panel board near the entrance is wired. For the distribution board, you need a 4-pole main circuit breaker, and a residual current device that is RCD, which is commonly known as the trip switch. Although I have shown this for a 3-phase system, selection and installation of an SPD for a single-phase system is not much different. From the distribution transformer, power supply is connected to the electricity meter first. After the meter, line is connected to the main circuit breaker. From the main breaker, the lines should be connected to the RCD. From RCD outer terminals, cables will be joined to more breakers, where equipment had been connected. Grounding wires from the equipment are connected to the ground connection bar, or so-called earth bar. Earth bar needs to be grounded correctly. If copper wire is used, the wire from the earth bar to the ground rod should have a minimum cross-sectional area of 10 square millimeters. Also, this size of ground wire is preferred for a system with a type 2 SPD. But if this system requires the installation of a type 1 SPD, it requires a copper wire of a minimum size of 16 square millimeters, from the ground bar to the ground rod. Before fixing the SPD, it requires an OCPD, that is an overcurrent protection device, to be connected in line with the SPD. Typically, this should be a cylindrical fuse holder, with the correct rated fuses intact. This is to isolate the SPD in the event of a failure, most likely after a direct lightning strike, and will prevent short circuits of the main lines through its damaged or strained internal parts. According to product testing standards for SPDs, manufacturers are required to declare the SCCR, that is the short circuit current rating of their SPD. Check the specifications on the instruction sheet to find out this value. Then install a type 1 SPD here at the entrance of the building, since the power supply is through aerial cables. Connect the main breaker output terminals to the input terminals of the fuse holder. Output terminals of the fuse holder required to be connected to the 4 input terminals of the SPD. Then, protective earth marked as PE need to be connected to the earth bar. If copper wire is used, minimum cross-sectional area of this cable for a type 1 SPD should be 16 square millimeters. To gain maximum effective protection from an SPD, the connecting conductors should be kept as short as possible. This will keep additional inductive voltage drops across the conductors in the SPD connection cables to a minimum. According to the standards, it is defined that an SPD installed in parallel, the cable lengths from the main breaker to the ground bar must not exceed 0.5 meters. To get a clear idea about selecting an SPD, let's first look at how the transient voltage spikes appear in the voltage sine wave. This is a 230 volt, 50 hertz frequency, AC supply, where the actual voltage alternates between a maximum of 325 volts and a minimum of -325 respectively. As this alternation works very fast, with a speed of 50 cycles per second, we take this voltage as the maximum continuous voltage of 230 volts, that is, RMS value or root mean square value. Here shows how the sudden voltage spikes appear in the voltage sine wave. These will reach a high peak value, but disappears quickly. Periodic time is the time taken for one voltage cycle, that is, to complete a full path of a sine wave. This is 1 over frequency. The frequency is given here as 50 Hz. When calculated, the time required for one cycle is 20 milliseconds. You know, 1 second is equal to 1000 milliseconds, and also to million microseconds. So the periodic time here is 20,000 microseconds. In general, most transient voltage spikes disappear within 30 microseconds. Although these transient overvoltages are comparatively short duration surges, it can reach up to 6 kV on 230-volt AC power lines. Most of these surges originate through lightning strikes or electrical switching of inductive loads. When continuous operation of an electronic system is required, it is essential to limit these peaks below the impulse immunity of the equipment. If we don't know the impulse voltage it withstands, simply take twice of the maximum voltage plus another 10% as the safe value for this. So, 715 volts is the safe range for electronic equipment here, and spikes within this range can be considered as harmless to critical equipment. Still, two spikes have exceeded this safe mark and will be harmful to electronic equipment in this system. If these spikes exceed 1500 volts, damage is imminent to electronic equipment such as computers, laptops, game consoles, monitoring equipment with digital displays, etc. If a transient surge reaches a point between these two values, there won't be any visible damage to the electronic equipment. But you will notice intermittent outages and slowing down of operating speeds due to degradation of these equipment, and some will face shorter lifespan thereafter. So, 2500 volts is the probable maximum impulse voltage that non-electronic electrical appliances can handle. An impulse marked on type 1 SPD is the impulse current of 10 microsecond waveform. What is a 10 microsecond waveform? It is the shape of the discharged current wave during a direct lightning strike. Rapidly rising surge current reaches its maximum value of 100% within the first 10 microseconds. Then it takes a total of 350 microseconds, fairly a long tail, to lower it to the half of that peak surge current. This term is used to show that the type 1 SPD is there mainly to divert partial current of a direct lightning strike to the ground. SPD type 1 should be installed at the entrance of a premises and need to make sure that the UP value is 2500 volts or closer to this value to achieve the best protection for non-electronic appliances. So, what is UP? UP is the voltage protection level of the SPD. It is the maximum voltage allowed to the load, and the current at this point is called IN. What is IN? IN is the nominal discharge current rating of the SPD. When a surge current of IN is applied to the SPD, still it is capable of limiting the voltage level to UP or less to the load side. However, this capability is limited at IN. But the SPD must perform at least for 15 surges with IN before its ultimate end of life. What is IMAX marked on SPD? IMAX is the maximum discharge current that the SPD can withstand for a single strike. This is also the maximum surge current that can be diverted by the surge protective device to the ground. Almost all SPDs will end their lifespan after receiving this one-time surge with IMAX and will show their green indication has turned to red. What is UC marked on SPD? UC is the maximum continuous operating voltage of the SPD. It is the maximum RMS voltage that can be continuously applied to the SPD without it being conducted. Any voltage above this clamping value will be diverted to the ground. What is the standard for an SPD? For a building to meet UL96A standard for lightning protection systems, it must have a type 1 SPD with a nominal discharge current rating of 20 kA installed at the service entrance. Further, IN is defined as surge current of 820 microsecond waveform, associated with type 2 SPD. What is 820 microsecond waveform? It is the type of current waveform generated by indirect lightning strike to a conductor. Also, majority of surge currents due to internal switching, that is due to on and off of heavy loads, will follow the same current waveform. Here, rapidly rising surge current reaches its maximum value of 100% within first 8 microseconds. Then it takes a total of 20 microseconds to get back to the half of that peak surge current. As mentioned earlier, 1500 volts is the maximum impulse voltage that an equipment with electronic parts will withstand. So, type 2 SPD is to be used at secondary distribution boards, when the distance from the main panel board at the entry point is more than 10 meters. We need to make sure that the UP value of type 2 SPD is around 1500 volts to achieve the best protection for equipment with electronic parts. Also, it is possible to use type 1 plus 2 combined SPD at the main distribution panel near the entrance, and type 3 SPD near the sensitive electronic equipment. What is SPD type 3? Most of these devices are cord connected and are direct plug-in type SPDs. Since these are with low discharge rating, it should be associated with the type 2 SPD. What is low discharge rating means? IMAX of type 3 SPD is generally around 10 kA, and is comparatively low when considering type 1 and type 2 SPDs. If a large 80 kA surge enters the building, it must be clamped through the type 1 and type 2 SPDs first, to reduce the remaining current to less than 10 kA, so that the type 3 SPD can successfully handle it. This controlled and effective distribution system of surge protection devices on panel boards is called a cascading surge protection system. Also, we need to make sure that the UP value of type 3 SPD is around 900 volts to achieve the best protection for sensitive electronic devices. Further, we need to select UC level closer to 285 volts for a 230 volts or 400 volts supply system. This SPD will divert anything above UC value to the ground, up to 900 volts. That means, if this SPD receives a 900 volt transient surge, it will allow 285 volts to the load side, and will divert balance 615 volts to the ground, within few nanoseconds. In general, all surge protectors respond within few nanoseconds, while transient surges will appear at a comparatively slower speed of few microseconds. Therefore, standard test specification for SPDs specifically states that response time should not be used as a specification for an SPD. I hope you now have a clear idea of how different types of SPDs work to protect electrical and electronic equipment from transient surges. If this video is helpful, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.